Good morning, students. Today I will teach you the remaining part of the chapter Human Circulatory System. Now, students, look into your books, page number 4, and see the table given showing difference between arteries and veins. So, let us begin. Difference between arteries and veins. Arteries carry oxygenated blood, whereas veins carry deoxygenated blood. That day I had told you that arteries carry blood from heart to different parts of our body. Now, arteries, which type of blood they carry? They carry oxygenated blood. Whereas veins, they bring back blood from different parts of body to heart. So, they bring deoxygenated blood from different parts of body to heart. Arteries have thick walls, veins have thin walls. Arteries do not have valves, whereas veins have valves. Blood flows at a high pressure in arteries, whereas blood flows slowly in veins. Now, all the arteries, they carry oxygenated blood except pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery arises from heart and goes to lungs. Now, veins, all the veins carry deoxygenated blood except pulmonary vein. Pulmonary vein arises from lungs and goes to heart. Now, let us come to some questions like, what is oxygenated and deoxygenated blood? Oxygenated blood means blood which is rich in oxygen, or we can say pure blood. What is deoxygenated blood? Deoxygenated blood means blood which has more carbon dioxide, or we say it's impure blood. Now, why arteries have thick walls? In arteries, blood flows with great pressure. So, to withstand that pressure, arteries have thick walls. Why arteries do not have valves, whereas veins have valves? Pressure of the blood from heart pumps blood to arteries, so they do not need valves. By the time the blood reaches the veins, the flow of the blood slows down. So, to prevent backflow of blood, the veins have valves. Why blood flows in jerks and at a high pressure in arteries? Pressure of the blood from heart keeps the blood at a high pressure in arteries. Or the blood flows at a high pressure in arteries because of the pressure of the blood from heart. Now, each time heart pumps, it pushes the blood a little further. So, the blood flows in jerks. So, students, we'll do the remaining pages next time. So, today I will teach you the remaining part of the chapter, that is Human Circulatory System. Pages 6 to 9. First topic, valves in heart. We have already discussed about the valves present in veins, which prevent backflow of blood in veins. Similarly, valves are present in heart also. Names of the valves: tricuspid, bicuspid, semilunar valves. Tricuspid valve's location is between the right auricle or atrium and right ventricle. Location of bicuspid valve between left auricle or atrium and left ventricle. Location of semilunar valves, one is at the opening of pulmonary artery and another semilunar valve is present at the opening of aorta. Functions of each. Now, tricuspid valve, as it is located between right auricle and right ventricle, so once the blood reaches right ventricle, it cannot flow back to right auricle because of closure of tricuspid valve. Next, bicuspid valve is located between left auricle or atrium and left ventricle. So once the blood reaches left ventricle, the backflow of blood into left auricle is prevented by closure of bicuspid valve. There are two semilunar valves, one which is located at the opening of pulmonary artery. The function of it is, once the blood goes to pulmonary artery, the backflow of blood into right ventricle is prevented by the closure of semilunar valve. Another semilunar valve which is present at the opening of aorta, that also closes when the blood flows into the aorta and prevents backflow of blood into the left ventricle. Now next, what is heartbeat? Heartbeat is rhythmic contraction and relaxation of heart. Pumping of blood by the heart can be heard as a regular thumping sound. These are called heartbeats. So, definition of heartbeat is rhythmic contraction and relaxation of heart. Every time our heart beats, blood is forced into the arteries. So, a wave of pressure which passes along the arteries is called pulse. A double tone sound can be heard in heartbeat. One is lub, another one is dub. Now, what is diastole? Relaxation phase of heart, that is when the ventricles are relaxed. What is systole? It's the contraction phase of heart when the ventricles contract. Diastole produces a dub sound, whereas systole produces a lub sound. What is stethoscope? An instrument which is used to listen to heartbeat. What is the heartbeat of a normal person? It is 72 times per minute. Now the third topic, that is exercise for healthy heart. Exercise makes the heart beat faster, bringing more blood to heart, and is good for our health. What is inhaling or inhalation? It is intake of pure air or air rich in oxygen into lungs through nose. What is exhaling or exhalation? It is releasing impure air or air having more carbon dioxide from lungs through nose. What is pranayama? It is a yogic practice of controlling your breath. Some deep breathing exercises of pranayama are kapalbhati, anulom vilom. Benefits of kapalbhati, anulom vilom are clearly given point wise in your chapter, so you will go through it. This way we complete the chapter Human Circulatory System.